When a person is sick, the impact of their illness is felt by every member of their family. And when there is no cure for that illness, the impact is even more devastating. That is where you come in. This weekend, an event combines polo with a promise to help.
His family was number one to Dad.
If you knew Billy McCauley, you knew this smile. And his daughter Joanna says you would see it when he talked about Greenville.
He spent his entire life caring about Greenville.
McCauley was the founder of Creative Builders, a leader in the upstate construction industry.
My father was the strongest man. I mean, he was so independent.
But in February, that independence was ripped away. McCauley was diagnosed with ALS, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease.
So I had to Google it. We all did, and we were all calling each other, my sister and my brother. We were all like, what in the world is ALS?
The disease was aggressive.
The patient is trapped in their body. Their mind is completely intact. It's my father getting on his tractor on Saturdays and not being able to do that. I mean, just those little things that he, you know, lost were, it was horrible. It was very hard, very hard.
Just 6 months after being diagnosed, Billy McCauley passed away in August. He was 69 years old.
I hate such a powerful word, but I hate ALS. I hate it.
But from hate comes help.
There are no centers like this here in the upstate.
Soon, this room will become part of the Greenville Hospital System's new neurological institute for people with diseases like epilepsy, Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis, and ALS. All under one roof.
And many times the disease process limits the person's ability to travel. And so if we can coordinate those resources in one location, then we're able to make sure that people have access to all the things that they need.
Money is needed to finish this project, and that is where horses come in. On Sunday, a polo classic will be held here at the historic Hopkins Farm in Simpsonville. All proceeds will benefit the Neurological Institute.
In the future, our family will be able to have one place to deal with the many aspects of ALS.
With your help, the city Billy McCauley loved can help other families coping with a devastating disease.
He would be so very proud of Greenville, so proud of Greenville for this happening.
If you'd like to go, the gates open at 1 p.m. this Sunday. Tickets cost $25. You can buy them at the gate. And if you'd like some more information, we've posted a link for you on our website, WYFF4.com. And my co-anchor here, this is very near and dear to your heart because you have been very involved with getting that clinic here and also planning this weekend's event.
Yeah, my father was diagnosed with ALS 2 years ago, and it's been the hardest journey of my life. We called in hospice about 3 weeks ago, and he's trying to hang on as best as possible. But, you know, this disease hit my family overnight, and it can happen to really anyone. And that is why it's so important that we get this here and now.
And get the word out about the importance of it.
Definitely.
And John's going to be there.
Yeah, you're going to be emceeing
on Sunday.
I am honored to be at the event. I really am. I hope we raise a ton of money.
Yeah.
I really do.
And it's going to be fun. Come on, we've never had polo in the upstate. How cool is that?
I know. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to it.
John's going to wear his big hat.
Yeah. I tell everyone it's the Kentucky Derby meets polo. So all the ladies will have hats. John will not have a hat.
Don't listen to Gab. Listen to Nigel. I will not be wearing one of those hats.
But it's going to be great.
Yeah, it's going to have a lot of fun. So come on out and say hello to us on Sunday.